friends. Today's new class is a quick morning yin-yang, which means, of course, it will be a little bit on the shorter side. It's meant to offer you something that you could do in the morning before starting your day, going off to work, etc., but it doesn't have to be done in the morning. And yin-yang means that we will kind of balance things out between work and rest or stretching. It's actually going to be in reverse order, yang, yin, although that doesn't have quite the same ring to it, so still gonna call it yin-yang. I'm gonna use a block for at least one of my yin poses at the end. You are more than welcome to have anything you like prop-wise. I always have a block handy just in case. So, we're gonna start seated, cross-legged, and let's side bend over to one side and then take the side bend into a twist to that same side. And then switch to side bend, other side, and then twist. Let's do a few more of those. And then next time you are in your twist, whichever side you're on, pause for just a moment and keep that hand on the knee that it's on. And then we'll release the twist and reach the other hand across for that opposite knee. And then take it into an eagle wrap if that feels accessible. If you prefer, a hug works too. And from here, let's do a little forward fold. You can let your back round so we can feel a little bit more stretchiness across the back. And let's come up and we'll release the arms, switch the cross of the legs for good measure. And we'll do our side bend to the other side and our twist, and we'll pause. Keeping that hand on the knee. Reach across for the opposite knee and then wrap your arms, a hug or something more like eagle, and then try folding. All right, let's come up, release the arms, and we'll come on to hands and knees next. Let's do a little cat-cow here. Inhaling as we tuck the toes and drop the belly, drawing the chest forward, exhale, pointing the toes, and rounding up. Let's keep going. Last round. And then let your spine settle into neutral-ish, just somewhere in the middle. And from here, let's bring the hands forward some and try to keep the hips over the knees approximately. And let's bring our elbows down, keeping them in line with the arms, and lift them back up. Let's start with that a few more times. Might start to feel a little work in the tricep area, those upper arms. All right, so we're gonna add a thing to what we're doing here. So after bringing elbows down, step one foot back and then the other, and you're in forearm plank, and you don't have to stay very long. Step back in, take your knees down, elbows up, elbows down. Start with the other leg stepping back into your forearm plank, and then step back in. Let's do a few more rounds of that. Feeling the work, for sure. Last round. walk those hands in a little bit, and let's take it up into downward facing dog, lifting the hips. And let's just kind of wiggle a little bit in that down dog shape, pedal the feet, shake your head, shake your hips, whatever feels nice. Okay. And then from down dog, we're going to pick up the right foot and bend that knee a bunch, like you're trying to squeeze something in between your calf and your hamstring. And you can either flex your foot or point your toes, or maybe try it both ways and see. But let's do some big circles with that right leg, keeping the knee bent and trying to keep down dog shape otherwise. And just a couple in one direction and then switch to the opposite direction. Okay, and then let's step that right foot forward and come down with the back knee for a low lunge. A little bit of movement here. So start by letting your hips sink as low as, you know, feels like a decent stretch. And then walk yourself back until your leg is straight-ish, toes down. And then lift the toes so you're flexing. From there, let your leg rotate out. Take a moment just to see how that feels. And then lift it and rotate it in. Take a moment, see how that feels. Come back up, walk it back forward. Let the hips sink down. Shift back, toes down, toes lifted, rotate out, up and rotate in, back up, walk it back forward. One more round. Next time we walk things back forward, let's tuck the back toes under and lift to a hands down lunge with the back knee up, right? We're gonna do a little flow a few times from here. All right, so we're gonna see if we can lift up into a warrior three with arms reaching back. Ooh, it's tricky. And then come back down to that hands down lunge. And then from here, back knee, see if you can bring it forward and tap as high up on your left arm as possible. And then step back. Warrior three, arms back. Hands down lunge. Back knee comes forward. Step back. Let's do one more time. Lift. Take it back down. Bring that knee forward. And back. From here, keep your back foot where it is. And straighten the front leg. And you can walk your hands back if that feels needed. Take a moment here. And let's keep that right leg straight as we spin the left heel down. So we've got triangle legs going on. And from here, we're going to kind of make a circle with the left arm as it reaches up in the direction of triangle. And then keep lifting and reach up into like a straight-legged reverse warrior kind of thing. And then back down from whence we came. Let's do a couple more times. Okay, this time as we're going forward, let's go ahead and bend the knee and come into side angle. And we're going to take this into another lunge variation. So we'll take our hands down and lift the back heel. And then reach up through the right arm for a twist. And then maybe the right arm stays up, maybe it wants to come down and give a little assistance. But let's try rolling to the left for side flip. And you can do any variation that you like. You can take your knee down, etc. And then lower to plank. Inhale. Like a push-up, exhale, chaturanga. Inhale. Up dog, active legs. Exhale, down dog. Maybe a little wiggle. Okay. So from down dog, let's switch sides. So we'll pick up the left foot and bend the knee a bunch. And you can try it, flex foot, pointed toes, doesn't really matter. Start your circles. Try to otherwise keep your down dog pretty stable and still.
We'll just do like two in one direction and then switch to the opposite direction.
And then let's bring that foot forward. Take the back knee down, low lunge. Hips move down a little bit more. Walk it back, straight leg-ish, toes down. Toes lifted, and then rotate out. Lift up and rotate in. Lift back up and walk it forward. We'll do that two more times. Forward, we'll take it into a hands down high lunge with the knee up, and from here warrior three, arms back, and then land again. Right knee comes forward and tries to tap as high up on that right arm as possible, and then step back. Warrior three, oh, balance, and then step back and knee forward. One more time because it's hard. Okay, after stepping back, straighten that front leg. Keep the leg straight, spin the back heel down, and then let's circle up with the right arm toward triangle, and then keep lifting into our reverse warrior variation. My joints are making some noise this morning. Let's do a couple more. And this time, as we're coming back forward, we'll bend the knee and go to side angle. And then we'll go to our lunge twist. So we'll take hands down, lift the back heel again, reach up through the left arm. And then we'll take it to side plank on the right side. Down the plank, inhale. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. Okay, let's keep the feet hip width-ish in down dog. Walk your hands back towards your feet as you bend your knees a lot and let your heels lift if they're not already. And let's just find a little toe squat. Take a moment just to kind of get your bearings, and when you're ready, try lifting your hands. They can do whatever. We're gonna lift all the way up, but try to keep the heels lifted, so we'll feel some things through the legs, and maybe even pause when you're maybe like halfway up to really feel those quads work. Keep going. Once we're all the way up, really stand up on those tippy toes and reach up through the arms. Lower the arms, back down, start to bend the knees again. Take it slowly. Maybe pause halfway down-ish. Feel that quad burn. Ooh, keep going, keep going. This is the painful part. When you get all the way down, it's not as bad. Okay, from this toe squat, let's widen the knees. And you might just kind of take your hands down for a moment. So we're gonna see if we can bring our knees up toward our armpits. We kind of practiced for that when we were bringing that knee forward in the lunge setup. So from here, try to keep your knees plugged to your arms. And bring your hands forward and rock forward and bring your elbows down and then lift up, and you might walk your hands in and kind of rock back and forth. And if you're feeling playful, as you come forward, you can come more forward and try doing a little baby crow, which is crow on forearms. Your seats, and we'll get on with our yin stretches. So, first one is straddle, legs wide. Feel free to turn on your mat if you feel more comfortable with that. And the legs don't have to be, you know, mine aren't ever going to straddle. So, just as wide as feels like it's going to be a good stretch. You could bend your knees, you could sit on a block or a pillow if that made it more comfortable. And then maybe a prop out in front of you to rest your head on or your arms or what have you. And we'll take a few minutes here. And breathe. My heart rate, my breath got a little faster for that baby crow stuff and for the balance stuff. So we'll take this time here to slow things back. Walk it up from there, and we're going to come down to our backs for our final little yin stretch, which will be a reclined twist. Because we did eagle arms earlier, I'm going to do eagle legs, just because that's how my brain likes to function. So you don't necessarily have to do that variation. If you want to just drop your legs over, that's fine too. All right, if you're doing eagle, whichever leg is on top, go in the opposite direction for your twist. So I've got my right leg on top and my legs are going to the left. You could have a block down to rest things on in some manner. I like to kind of happy medium with the legs going over and the opposite shoulder staying down. It doesn't really matter necessarily as long as it feels comfortable for you. And we'll take a little time here.
choose a different variation if you're not feeling the eagle legs. When you're ready, go ahead and take it over. Maybe you want to walk to help prop up.
Stretch. I hope that helps you to set a good tone for your day. Thank you so much for joining me, and I look forward to practicing with you again soon. Have a great day.